Hey guys, what's up? It's Brandon from soldwithvideo.com here, and today we're going to show you how to set up a website, and you can literally do it in about 15 minutes. And not only that, we have a cool bonus for you guys at the end of this video. So what are we waiting for? Let's just get right into it. Okay, so this how to make a website tutorial is actually part of the live marketing challenge where I'm taking a local based business, marketing it online, and showing everyone exactly how to do it. If you guys are interested in following along, you can go to this link at the end of the video. But enough with that, let's get right into this tutorial. In this tutorial, we're gonna show you how to set up a website. It could be a small business website, a company website, a personal website, a blog, or almost any other type of website. And we do this with one piece of completely free software called WordPress. So I hope you enjoy, and let's move on to step number one. The first step is to register your domain name. Your domain name is going to be the name of your website. So my website is soldwithvideo.com, and that is my domain name, soldwithvideo.com. Now you need to come up with a domain name for your website. It could be your business name or whatever you want it to be. I would come up with a list of a few different domain names, because your domain name may not be available. If someone already registered the domain name that you want, it's not going to be available and you cannot get it. So write down a couple names because yours may not be available. Now as you get into step two, you realize you also need to buy a hosting package. I like to use a company called hostmonster.com because they actually give you a completely free domain name when you buy a hosting package from them. So you need to buy hosting anyways, you might as well go through HostMonster, who's going to give you a completely free domain name. And another reason why I like HostMonster is because they allow you to host unlimited amount of websites on your hosting package. They give you unlimited amount of email addresses, so you can have email addresses like info@yourdomainname.com. They also give you unlimited amount of databases and a ton of other benefits. So I really recommend HostMonster.com. It's the company I personally use, and I haven't had any problems with them, and I recommend them to everybody. So if you go through our link below, you'll actually be redirected to their site, and you'll also be presented with the best prices possible. So if you go through our link, they'll have the best prices possible for you guys. Now, I know some of you may already have a domain name registered at a different company, and that's completely fine. All you need to do is tell them, hey, I'm having another company do my hosting and I need you to change the name servers on my domain name to ns1.hostmonster.com and ns2.hostmonster.com. And it's okay if you don't understand what that means, because they will understand exactly what you're talking about. And once they do that, then your domain name will be linked up to your HostMonster hosting account. So if you already have a domain name and it's registered someone else, just tell them to change the name servers and then you're good to go. You need to come back to HostMonster and then we'll go through the rest of the steps. So let's move on to the next step. And I'm already on HostMonster.com's homepage. And if you're looking at this at a future date, the prices may change and the look of their site may change depending on what kind of sales and stuff they have going on. But again, if you go through our link, we'll give you the best prices possible. So this is what it currently looks like as this video is being done. But if it looks different in the future, don't worry about it. It's still fine and you're still going to get the good quality HostMonster account. So go ahead and hit sign up now. All right, so now we're brought to the next page where we need to register our domain name. You have an option on the right. And if you already have your domain name, you want to enter it in here and then hit next. And then if you've already changed your name servers, you're going to be good to go. If not, HostMonster will actually tell you what to change your name servers to and how to do it. So now most of you probably don't have a domain name yet. So go ahead and type in the desired domain name that you want right here. Enter in your best choice. And what's going to happen is HostMonster is going to go through and see if it's actually available for you. So I'm just going to type in domainname.com and then hit next. Okay, so as you can see, domainname.com was not available because someone already registered that name. But HostMonster went through and gave me a list of domain names that are available for me to use. So I can kind of go through the list and see if I want to use any of these as my domain name. And if you don't, that's perfectly fine. You can go down below and retype in a new name to try. And then it'll go through the same process. It'll tell you whether or not that domain name is available or if it isn't, and you know, give you some more recommended domain names. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose a domain name here at the top so we can go on to the next step. So now we're moving on to step two, which is picking out the hosting package that we're going to want.
you need to buy a hosting package with your domain name, otherwise your website will not be online. The domain name is just the name. The hosting package is actually what puts the website online. So now that we have our domain name chosen, we're going to go ahead and fill in our account information. You can enter it in here. And as we scroll down, you'll be able to see they have a couple more options and upgrades for different hosting packages. For most of you, you probably don't need to upgrade to the Power package or the Pro package, but if you do in the future, it's pretty easy to do. So I would start off with just the basic package because you don't need to spend $19 a month on something you don't need. So now we get down to package information, and they have a drop-down menu here where you can choose the plan that is perfect for you. So go ahead, look through their options and choose the plan that is perfect for you in your business or you and your website. And as you can see, they have a couple upsells here. They have a site lock domain security, which you probably don't need because they send you updates and stuff when your domain name's expiring, but you can buy that if you want. You don't necessarily need it. I don't usually buy it. And then they have Site Backup Pro. This is a backup program that will automatically update and, or not update, but back up your website. So in case anything does happen, it goes down, files are lost, they have backup versions of your site for you. They do have a basic backup plan on your website that's included in your hosting package. So I would not buy this now, but if you need to upgrade in the future because the basic backup plan doesn't work for you, then you can do it at that time. But when you're first starting out, you probably don't need this. The next one is in Search Engine Jumpstart. You probably won't need that. And now we're at Domain Whois Privacy. Now, I do recommend that you buy this because what happens is anyone can look up a website or a domain name and get all of the information that you entered in above. So anyone can go to any Whois site and look up the Whois information for any domain name. And they'll give that person your phone number, your address, your email address, and your name. Now, most of the time, that's not gonna be a problem, but you never know. So I recommend spending the $9.99 it is and have it protected, which means if you buy that, no one will be able to see your information if they look up the Whois information on your domain. So I do recommend it, but it's up to you. If you want your information protected, go ahead and buy it. If you don't, then just leave that box unchecked. And then the next field is the billing information, and then you hit next. Okay, now that your account is created, you're ready to set up your website, which is actually step number 3. They're gonna give you an email that looks like this and show you how to log into your site, your account information, and any other additional information on the right side. This is where you'll find the name servers just in case you already bought a domain name. If you bought the domain name through HostMonster, then you don't even need to worry about changing the name servers. So go ahead and log into your account. To do this, you're going to go to their homepage and click Control Panel Login. Once you're on this page, you enter in your account information they just emailed you and hit Login. All right, now that you're logged in, what we want to do is install WordPress. Like I mentioned before, WordPress is completely free and it's a website and blog management system. It allows you to upload a theme literally in a few seconds, and that will completely change the look and layout of your entire site. Now, you can buy different themes at sites like themeforest.net, or you can look online and try to find downloads of free WordPress themes. Now, if you're going to download free WordPress themes, I would really recommend doing it from a secure site to avoid downloading anything with some spam or firmware or viruses or anything like that. Make sure it is a completely secure site and a trusted source. So the first step is going to be installing WordPress. Now that we're logged into our cPanel in HostMonster, what we're going to do is go down to the Simple Scripts tab here. You can see Simple Scripts here or WordPress. If the WordPress option is available, go ahead and click directly on that. If it isn't, go ahead and click on Simple Scripts. Okay, once you click on Simple Scripts, you're going to come up with a list like this, which is a whole list of scripts that HostMonster actually gives you access to. So what we want to do is go ahead and click on WordPress. Once you click on WordPress, you're going to be brought to the installation page. As you can see, I have it installed on a few different sites, but for you, you're probably only going to have one site when we're doing this, so you just scroll to the bottom and hit Install. Once you hit install, it's going to ask you which site you would like to install WordPress on. Now, if you own a couple domains like I do, you'll have a drop-down menu. If you only have the one domain name, it'll be available in that box. So I'm going to go ahead and install it on one of my domain names. And I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. make sure this box is checked, otherwise it won't let you install. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit complete. Now it's installing WordPress and it should just take a few seconds. Okay, as you can see, WordPress was successfully installed and they gave us all of our information here to be able to log in. I would write this information down, but they should send you an email as well, just in case. So let's go ahead and check out our site and see if WordPress was installed. There you have it. Our website is now up and running. That did not take very long at all. In fact, it just took a few minutes. But as you can see on the site, it's pretty plain, pretty basic, and pretty boring. So I'm going to show you guys what you can do to spice it up and how you can install a theme to get a professional looking website in just a few clicks. So let's go ahead and do that right now. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and log in with the information that they gave me here. And now I'm logged into my website's admin area. So the first thing we want to do is go over to appearance, and then a pop-up menu will come up to the right. Choose the themes option. Now we're in our theme section. This is where you're going to be able to change the layout of your site. So what we want to do is either choose one of the layouts that they already give us down here, or you can go to install themes. Now this allows you to search for themes that is in WordPress's database, and usually they're all free. So you can either use the filters down here to choose a site that you like, or you can enter in a search in this field right here. So you can enter in a keyword here and search for themes. So let's type in a keyword. We'll type in professional. So we want a professional looking website. So it pulls up professional looking themes that we can install on our website. So here's one here called corporate. Let's go ahead and install it. We hit the install now button right underneath. Now it's installing, and as you can see, it already installed and was successful in just a few seconds. So next thing we need to do is hit activate. Now that we hit activate, that theme is live on our website. So let's go and check it out. There you go. We have a completely custom professional looking website done for us in just a few clicks. Now obviously you need to go through and change out the information so that it's your information. You don't want all of this basic information here. You want your information, and you can even change out the images and stuff like that. Now as you can see, we set up a professional looking website in just a matter of minutes. It did not take very long. But when you start going through these themes and editing out and inserting your own information, it may take you a little bit longer than 15 minutes, especially if you're not used to WordPress. But here's the thing, with a lot of these free templates like that, they don't offer a lot of instructions on how to be able to edit things. Some of them do, some of them don't. So if you buy a theme, usually they'll come with instructions on how to be able to edit it. So I'm going to go back and show you how to install a theme that you bought. Okay, so now we're back in our admin area under Manage Themes. And as you can see, this one does have some easy to use options where you can change out the information pretty simply. But let's say you bought a pretty cool looking theme on themeforest.net and you downloaded it and now you're ready to install it. How do you do that? So all you need to do is just go to Install Themes, hit Upload, and then choose the file on your computer. So since it's a zip file, you're going to look for that zip file on your computer. And then you're going to hit Install Now. Now as you can see, it installed successfully in just a few seconds. So the next step is to hit activate. Okay, now that it activated, you can see here that we have a complete layout of being able to change anything on that template. It's pretty cool. They have a complete layout here, and you can always access that theme right here on the left side. So let's go ahead and see if that change went through on our website. So we're going to go ahead and refresh the page, and there you go. Our new theme is now up and live. Although I do like the other one a little bit better, but this is primarily just to show you how to do it. So if you guys do buy any themes or anything like that, or you download some free ones from a website, or you take advantage of this cool bonus we're going to give you in a second, that's how you're going to be able to install the themes very easily. So let's go back into our admin panel and go back to our themes, appearance and themes. Every theme that we update will be saved right here, so you can activate them at any time and switch between themes if you want to. Now I know how much time it takes to go through a lot of different themes, test them and see which one works, and if you end up buying a couple of themes, it ends up getting expensive. So what we did for you guys is put together 10 of our favorite WordPress templates and themes that you can use completely for free. And if you want instant access to our top 10 favorite themes for free, all you need to do is just go to soldwithvideo.com/themes and get your free themes today. And on this page, we'll also have resources that were mentioned in this video, and we'll give you ability to get those themes for free. So just go to soldwithvideo.com/themes. You'll be able to get instant access to those free themes that we're giving you guys, and you'll have all the resources you need. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to set up a website. And as you can see, we did it in just a few minutes. Now, I understand if you're new to this, it may take you a little bit longer and you will need to go out and change the information on these themes. But this is the fastest and cheapest way to be able to set up a website. I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch this video. And if you want more videos like this in the future, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos. All right, guys, this is Brandon from soldwithvideo.com signing out.
I need to look more professional. How's this? Come on, screen's weird. That screen's weird, my hands look funky. They look huge, look how big my hands are.